I was diagnosed on my birthday, October 17th. Yes, it was a great birthday present.
The oncologist first sent me home to die because there's nothing we can do for you.
One of the best oncologists I know said to me, you can put your 81-year-old mother through chemotherapy and radiation for stage 4 lung cancer, but in my professional opinion, she has less than 3 weeks to live. She died 18 days later.
People want to know. They want to know it in understandable words. They want you to tell them again and again and again because you can't hear it the first time.
Well, when you're just thinking about retirement and then you're told you're going to die, I did something I've never done and that I can remember. I cried.
Lung cancer is the number one cause of cancer death in the United States for both men and women.
When somebody has lung cancer, there's a presumption they must have gotten it because they smoked. That has set back the public's interest in lung cancer for decades.
We're seeing more and more that non-smokers are also having lung cancers much more so than ever before.
As the general population tendency to smoke has decreased, lung cancer has remained a major disease problem.
Patients that have cancer never deserve to be treated like they caused this problem.
If someone has a heart attack, do you say, well, you probably ate too much fried chicken, so it's not our problem?
When somebody has diabetes, you don't blame them for having bad genetics.
Patients don't deserve to be treated like that. They should be treated with compassion.
It used to be predominantly a male disease, and now it is very much a woman's disease.
Twice as many women die of lung cancer as die of breast cancer.
Middle-aged women who have never smoked, and we really don't know why.
We lose about one person every 2 hours in the state of Georgia from this disease.
Georgia is on the front line of increasing hope and compassion and support for this disease.
Imagine what impact it had on Coca-Cola when Roberto Goizueta died of lung cancer. So this is not a private fight.
Why isn't lung cancer on the front page of a newspaper? Boy, isn't that the question of the day. Knowing that it's no less than a tsunami hitting our shores every year.
And there's not a single person I know who doesn't know somebody who's died of lung cancer.
The public has really not understood that lung cancer is everybody's battle.
The public should join up with us and help us in this fight because this is the public's fight.
How can I help? What should I do to be able to help?
Don't send flowers. Send some dollars in there. Every dollar that we get in Atlanta is back into the state of Georgia. We don't keep a dollar for ourselves.
Our philosophy is that awareness begets more research, begets more change in Congress, which is what the Lung Cancer Alliance is all about.
They do know who we are, and they know that we're a force to be reckoned with.
Lung Cancer Alliance is here for the patients that get lung cancer, to help them to walk their way through it, to do it in an informed way.
To provide hope, to provide compassion, and to provide support for anyone who is faced with having to figure out how to manage this illness or to determine whether or not they even could be at risk for it.
If you find it when it's at its earliest stages, you will win the battle.
I was dying. I was sent home to die. And I'm still here.
In 3 weeks, I finish chemo, and my body will heal, and I'll go on with life.
You can stay ahead of it. You can live a normal life. You can have a good life.
We can make it reality that lung cancer mortality could be cut in half in 5 years if we got behind it.
Lung cancer is no different than any other cancer. It deserves the same compassion and treatment that all other cancer gets, and it is totally and completely curable.
Lung cancer is winnable. It is a curable disease.
It is winnable.
It's winnable, it's winnable, it's winnable.
Lung cancer can be won.